All right, let's go, buddy. Let's get you some water. Okay, hold on. Let me put the boat.
Look, Meg, I don't know what your problem is. I thought Dad's humming was pretty entertaining.
You know what? This is what I'm talking about. This is a perfect example.
Meg, please.
Not now, Mom.
I think Brian's getting a little water in there.
Chris, you treat me like you hate me, and I don't know why. You say hurtful things to me constantly.
Still drinking.
Is it too much to ask to be treated with a little decency from my brother? Maybe show me some kind of kindness by not jumping on the Let's Get Meg family bandwagon? Hey, I got an idea, Mom. How about we talk about Chris's mother, huh? Why don't we talk about you?
Oh, God, that feels so much better.
You know, Brian, you may be a dog, but you're a pretty cool cat.
Yes, you're right, Brian, there is. Meg seems to think she's taken some kind of stand here that's gonna make us all feel like we're inadequate.
Hey, you can't park here!
Excuse me?
Having been officially challenged by her natural enemy, in the impending battle, a flock of Jews flies quickly away, as avoiding confrontation is their best chance for survival.
Look, the bottom line here, Meg, is that you're just taking your own problems out on everyone else.
Oh, my problems? Oh, I see. Is this coming from my role model mother? Are you? Are you a better person?
What's your point, Meg?
My point is that with all the irresponsible, reckless, idiotic behavior in your past, that somehow...
All right, well, fine. Okay, I'm not the perfect mother. Who is?
Oh, not only are you not the perfect mother, you're the farthest thing from. You have done none of those things. You're my mother, and you took a child's trust and smashed it into bits in a 17-year-long mission to destroy something that you killed a long time ago.
Oh, wow, everybody's already tweeting Stewie just said that.
God.
And you never let Dad stir the paint anymore, whatever that means.
I didn't know you knew that, Meg, but I'm glad you brought it up.
Oh, Meg, I don't know what to say. All of those things you said about me are true. I have been a very bad mother to you.
Yeah, you're a bitch.
Well, you know, I've been sort of just hanging back here, taking all this in, because I didn't think I had a dog in this fight, but my money's on Harry Potter over there.
Oh, I'll tell you, Mr. Selfish-Ass Dad.
Hey, that's Mr. Selfish-Ass Dad to you, young lady.
Oh, God, is she gonna do me next?
You have no education, you have no interest, you just do whatever reckless thing you want to do, whenever you want to do it, without regard for anyone else. If someone in the outside world could see the way you treat me, you would be in jail. You've lived half your life, and you have nothing to show for it. Your only arguable accomplishments are your kids. And look at us. We're a disaster.
Wait a second. These are criticisms. Hey, Lois, tell her to knock it off.
Oh, and where the hell were you when she was laying into me?
I was thinking about getting a fancy cane.
Dad did. Look, he's got crap on his ears.
That's unrelated.
Chris, I don't like that language.
Well, I don't like your cooking.
Well, I don't like having to literally empty the farts out of your pockets whenever I do your laundry.
Why don't we ever get any good food?
Yeah, Bonnie gives Joe Wonder Bread.
Well, then go live at Bonnie's house. Then I could finally sleep in and not have to answer your stupid questions at 5 a.m. You know, I've never confronted you on it, but I've often thought the same thing, Peter.
Yeah, that's exactly what he does, because he's a selfish, fat idiot.
You shut up, all he is. I didn't ask to be in this family!
Hey. What's going on? You know, that was pretty cool, the way you finally stood up to everyone.
Do you think it's possible that this family can't survive without some sort of lightning rod to absorb all the dysfunction?
Wow. You know, that's incredibly noble and mature, Meg. You know, I think you might be the strongest person in this house.
You mean that, Brian?
Absolutely.
Dad?
Go away!
Dad, come out of there.
No! I don't deserve no better than living with the shoes!
Chris, you're an outstanding brother. What I said about you was more about me being a rotten sister. And Dad, I'm so sorry that I made you feel this way. You don't deserve it.
Oh, so this was all about you. It wasn't about us.
Yeah.
All right, that makes sense. See, I thought it was weird that I was a bad dad.
Hi, I'm Stewie Griffin. Tonight's Family Guy was a very special episode about drug use.
Hey, Horace, another round for everybody.
Yeah! Gosh, Peter, you're really being generous with your money.
Hey, what's the point of being rich if you can't share it with your pals, huh?
Hey, I got one, Peter. What would you rather do? tread water where you are right now, or increase your net worth fivefold within the next 18 months.
Huh? What are you talking about? Well,
Peter, I've taken the liberty of mocking up some sales projections.
Wow, that's pretty good.
And this would be our net profits.
Hey, yeah, if you're gonna open your mouth with the missus, stick to kisses, eh?
What neat humor! What neat humor!
So what do you say, Peter? Can you help us out?
La 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 la.
Yeah, I understand. You got other things to do. I just wrote you guys a couple of checks. But no, you do your things.
What?
No, I mean, I'm just saying. I thought friends hang out, do things with each other. You know, especially when one friend gives the other friends a whole bunch of money. That's more like it. From now on, we're all going to do whatever I want to do, because I'm the one with the dough.
Okay, I guess that's fair.
Good, because what I want to do is stay here, get drunk, and watch TV.
Hey, Peter, you wanted me to watch the entire first season of True Blood and come show you where there was boob?
That's right. I don't want to see any actual True Blood, just boob.
I didn't write it.
Yeah, but you know the people who do. That Alan Ball, you know him, right?
Yeah.
How come everything he writes is so dreary?
I don't know.
Tell him to cheer up. Things ain't so bad.
Another season. Another reason
for making whoopee.
Look, you aren't gonna shoot us in the eye, are you, Peter?
Hey, Joe, open your eye. Gotcha.
What the hell, Peter? You shot him in the eye.
Keep singing, you. And keep your chin up so I can see your throat.
No, screw this. You're a jerk.
Fine, go on. I don't care. I don't need you. I got money.
You know, Peter, you used to be a great guy. But ever since you won that lottery... Come on, Joe! This guy!
Peter, my God, what the hell are you wearing?
It's a solid gold tuxedo, Lois. I had to fight three rappers down at the nonsense store for this.
You know, I spoke to Bonnie this morning, and she said you haven't talked to Joe or Quagmire in 2 weeks.
Who cares? I don't need Quagmire. And I certainly don't need Joe. I got money, Joe.
This is nice. I hope that bear comes around soon. That's sort of my favorite. Oh, look, the bear!
Your fancy rag, sir.
You are relieved for the evening. You don't see poor people doing this!
Oh, my God. Peter, it's beautiful. Is it a blood diamond?
Ah, the bloodiest. Chris, Meg, now that I'm a rich father, you will try to impress me and I will remain distant. Go.
Say, Dad, did I tell you I got second place in the yacht race?
No. Meg, as a girl, your life holds no merit. And Chris, try as you may, you will never be as good as your older brother who died. He was good at sports and talking. Now pardon me while I look at Scrimshaw through a magnifying glass. Waiter, have the chef prepare a bucket of your finest caviar and then give it a helicopter tour of the city.
Very good, sir.
Very good indeed. I hope it enjoys it as much as that Maine lobster I ordered.
Well, actually, sir, your card has been declined.
Oh, really? Well, I'm sure a brief call to my accountant will resolve this to our mutual satisfaction. They did what with it? No, I don't want it back! I'm gonna miss you, Carstairs.
I shall miss you too, sir.
With no one to look after, Carstairs fell into a deep depression from which he never emerged.
I can't believe it. We lost everything.
What do we do now?
Well, seems like our only hope is the lottery.
Hi.
Hello.
Hey,
Dad.
Hi.
And that's not even Kyle.
Peter, we can't live like this.
Well, what are we supposed to do, Lois? Everything we had is gone.
We have friends, Peter.
Not anymore, we don't.
Well, well, look who it is.
Who is it?
It's me, Peter. I'm standing right here. I thought being rich would solve all my problems, but all it did was make me forget what was important. Like who my real friends are. I don't expect you to forgive me, but...
That corner's a bit of a hike for me. I'd rather just come see you at home.
What? Where'd you get this kind of money?
You're welcome. And if it makes you feel better, it was money well spent. Just ask Sandra, the waitress over there. We had a great time last night.
Yeah, despite all the ups and downs, things turned out for the best. I mean, really, we're no worse off than we were before. Plus, we learned something, and you can't put a price on that.